Hello, and welcome to Ask Excite. I'm Tim Bushnell with Expert Cytometry, and today's question comes from Kathy, who asks, how do you set PMT voltages? Now, Kathy, that's a great question, a very important one. I'm going to start by optimizing my PMTs, and I'll refer back to episode 30, where we talk about the peak 2 method. The goal of that method is to determine the best, most sensitive part of the PMT. Once we have that, we can do a further refinement of setting our voltages based upon the specific fluorochromes that we're using in our panel. To do that, we stain our cells with our antibodies, properly titrated, of course, and then we run a voltage titration or voltration where we run those cells over voltage range and measure the staining index to find the optimal index. What that will do is determine if you have the best voltage based upon your previous optimization, or there might be a better voltage where you get better separation. Now, once you have that, you want to set up some method, and I use the peak 6 method so I can track that voltage. And so I have target values using the bead, the peak 6 bead, that relate back to that original optimization. Once I've done that, I create a template, and every time I go to the instrument, I put those peak 6 beads on, I check my voltage, make sure I'm hitting my target values, and then I start running my cells. Thanks for the question, Kathy, and remember, if you have questions, go to getflowtraining.com to learn more. And if you have a question you want answered here, send it to askexcite@expertcytometry.com. Thanks for another edition of Ask Excite. Until next time, be sure to keep up with the best practices in flow cytometry right here with your friends in flow, Tim and Team Excite.